This plastic surgery video goes over the use of a surgical drain. This surgical drain is called a Jackson-Pratt drain. This drain is used to evacuate fluid from within inside of a wound. These drains have a reservoir that is outside the patient, and it's very simple to use. It works by suction, and the patient will take the drain and take the cap out and then squeeze the drain and close it like so. And what happens is the drain will stay compressed. So the drain actually has a firm rubber or silicone reservoir which will try and expand. And as it expands, it creates a suction. And I'm going to let it expand now so that you can see what happens. And you'll see it won't do this that quickly. It will do it very slowly. I don't know if you can appreciate this, but this drain has numbers on it which show the reservoir volumes of how much fluid is actually coming out of the wound. This black dot is a reference point we use as to how deep the drain is actually in the patient. This is the end of the drain that actually goes in the patient, and you can see here that it's actually fluted. The fluted drain is the part that actually goes in the patient, and we can actually trim this length of drain depending on how big of a wound. So if this was to be in a patient, it actually is the part that sucks the fluid into the drain tube, and then it collects in the reservoir. The reservoir over time will fill up, and once the reservoir fills up, it'll have to be emptied. And the way it is emptied is similar to what I demonstrated earlier. The cap is removed. The volume is actually squirted into a container, and the container is registered, and we figure out how much volume has actually been emptied out. Then the bulb is compressed and is put back like that. And then because it's under suction, it will stay like this. Every 4 hours or so on the first day, you will record the outputs. And to do that, you would have a drain output sheet. What you see here is on the day of surgery, and then the subsequent days are recorded on the one side of the paper, as well as the number of drains that a particular patient might have. Most patients will only have one or two drains depending on how big of a surgery and if I'm operating on one side or two sides. What you should also notice is that on the day of surgery, the frequency of emptying the drain is about every 4 hours. And that's because we want to make sure that the drain is adequately sucking at all times, and usually that's a frequent enough interval that it will allow most of the fluid to come out. As you go farther from surgery, you'll notice that the frequency of the drain changes to every 6 hours. So basically 4 times a day you empty out the drain. And then you would write those values in the column and you add them up every day. By having this type of record for your post-operative days, we can determine when the volume has dropped to a safe enough amount that we can remove the drain and do it safely so that we don't have to worry about any fluid collecting. As far as maintenance of the drain, other than recording the drain outputs, what we have to do is demonstrate what it looks like when a drain is in somebody. And so for demonstration purposes, we're going to pretend the hand right here is actually the patient, and it's inside of her skin or inside of her abdomen or her breast or anywhere else I need it. And so this is what the drain actually looks like inside of a patient or from the outside of the patient. So her skin or her body will be right here, and the drain will actually be sewn into the skin and secured tightly so it cannot come out. And this length of tube will vary depending on the area that she's had the drain placed or he's had the drain placed. So this length can be very short, and this would be considered a very short drain, and this is only 24 inches or so. And so this would actually, if this was the patient's breast, this would hang down to about her waist. And if this was her abdomen, this would hang down to about her knee. The idea is that you can have enough extra tubing so that this can be safely and comfortably stored either in a pants pocket or with a safety pin that can be pinned to a shirt. So the drain is in the patient, it's been sewn in, and we've already talked about how to empty the drain and how to record the values. The only other thing that you have to do to a drain is what's called stripping the drain. And what happens is that as this tube, as this drain sucks fluid in, it will also suck in some blood, and the blood will tend to clot in the tube. And if the tube gets clotted, the drain stops working. So what we have the patients do is actually take an alcohol pad or a face cloth and basically hold the drain close to the body so that they don't pull it out, and then gently pinch it and pull the drain. And you can see I'm actually stretching the drain. My fingers are not moving. Now I'm going to lightly let my fingers move, and then I go down the drain, and I would actually be working any clot into the tube. And as you do this, this bulb would actually be filling up with the clot. And then when you let go of it, the tubing itself would be clear. So in essence, you have stripped the drain to make sure that it's patent or open, and then this way, it will function to maximum capacity, and that will allow us to record and safely manage the outputs from the wound. This will actually increase your speed of recovery and improve your aesthetic results.